This is Channel 32, WFLD Chicago. And now Channel 32 brings you this thought for today. Speaking is John M. Siedem, pastor of Trinity Slovak Lutheran Church in Chicago.
We all arrive at a time when we criticize our fellow workers, our work, our friends, our schools, our government, and even our loved ones. When we are critical, we are displaying a built-up bitterness in ourselves. Bitterness, in turn, indicates a lack of love. We have all heard the expression, God is love. So let us learn from God how to love. The greatest definition of love is recorded in the Bible by St. Paul in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecies, they will pass away. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. For our knowledge is imperfect, and our prophecy is imperfect. But when the perfect comes, the imperfect will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I gave up childish ways. But now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, then I will understand fully, even as I have been fully understood. So faith, hope, love abide. These three, but the greatest of these is love.
You've been listening to The Thought for Today with John M. Siedem, pastor of Trinity Slovak Lutheran Church in Chicago. This is television station WFLD-TV, Channel 32, Chicago, owned and operated by Metromedia Incorporated, with transmitter atop the John Hancock Building and executive offices and studios located at 300 North State Street, Chicago, Illinois. WFLD-TV operates on an assigned frequency of 578 to 584 megahertz, as assigned by the Federal Communications Commission. Some programs and portions of programs presented by this station are recorded. WFLD-TV's entire broadcast schedule is a copyrighted original work. No recording, retransmission, or other use may be made of WFLD-TV's programming without the express prior written consent of Metromedia Incorporated. We welcome your comments with regards to our programming. Address your correspondence to Dirk Zimmerman, Vice President and General Manager, WFLD-TV, Marina City, 300 North State Street, Chicago, Illinois, 60610. This is Channel 32, WFLD, Chicago. Good morning. This is television station WFLD-TV, Channel 32, Chicago, owned and operated by Metromedia Incorporated, with transmitter atop the John Hancock Building and executive offices and studios located at 300 North State Street, Chicago, Illinois. WFLD-TV operates on an assigned frequency of 578 to 584 megahertz, as assigned by the Federal Communications Commission. Some programs and portions of programs presented by this station are recorded. WFLD-TV's entire broadcast schedule is a copyrighted original work. No recording, retransmission, or other use may be made of WFLD-TV's programming without the express prior written consent of Metromedia Incorporated. We welcome your comments with regards to our programming. Address your correspondence to Dirk Zimmerman, Vice President and General Manager, WFLD-TV, Marina City, 300 North State Street, Chicago, Illinois, 60610.
And now Channel 32 brings you this thought for today. Speaking is Reverend Carl B. Wilson, pastor, Mandel United Methodist Church, Chicago.
Our subject for this evening, Jesus Makes the Difference. In the 14th chapter of Matthew, we find a crowd following Jesus into the wilderness. One thing we note is that whenever Jesus went around preaching and teaching, he always drew a crowd, because the words that he spoke were compelling to the human heart. The miracles he performed were like none they had ever seen. By the end of this particular day, the disciples had come to Jesus and said, "It is already past time for dinner, and there's nothing here to eat in the desert." They said to Jesus, "Send the crowds away that they may go into the villages and find food." Jesus replied, "That is not necessary. You feed them." They exclaimed, "We have but two fish and five loaves. What is so little among so many?" Certainly in the world that we live in today, we experience shortages in many respects. As we look around our world, we see shortages in natural resources, housing, employment, patience, yes, even a shortage of understanding and love. But one thing we realize as we examine this passage is that the disciples, when they looked at the crowd which seemed so large, and at their resources which seemed so small, they became discouraged. But Jesus said to them, "Bring what you have." And according to our scripture, the Lord looked toward heaven and he gave thanks for what he had been given. And after the Lord had given thanks, he broke the bread and used the two fish and five loaves to begin feeding the crowd. And after they had eaten sufficiently, there was even more food remaining. Each of us must follow that example of Christ and bring what we have to the Lord, and give thanks to the Lord for what we do have, even though it may not seem like much to us. Also, we must use what we have, even though it doesn't seem like enough to do the job. For if we give thanks, and if we use what we have in the service of the Lord, we will see that he will make up for any shortage that we have. Certainly, Christ is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh within us. Yes, things which are impossible with people are possible with God.
You've been listening to The Thought for Today with the Reverend Carl B. Wilson, pastor, Mandel United Methodist Church, Chicago.
a drinking driver is like a loaded gun. Both can be deadly.
This is Channel 32, WFLD-TV, Metromedia in Chicago.